why are the pieces of land and the white water that breathe out fire and smoke made of different types of rocks? In the wide, deep water of our world, there are little pieces of land with rocks that breathe out fire and smoke. These pieces of land are formed because they lie on top of hot spots in the inner part of our world. They are so hot that the rock changes. It becomes soft like water, and it goes up to the top of the world really quickly, where it is thrown out as fire, little rock pieces, and smoke. Over time, these rocks make a new piece of land, and because the top of the world moves over the inner part of our world, where the hotspot stays fixed, new pieces of land often form in lines, making a hotspot track. But sometimes there is not only one, but there are two lines next to each other, and they each have a different rock type. If we look down very deep in the rock-filled inner part of our world, the spots lie on top of the edges of areas filled with something that we think might be hot, heavy rocks. And the lines of pieces of land with different rock types at the top of our world often seem to run in the same direction as the edges of these areas of heavy rocks very deep in our world. This does not look like it could happen just by chance. So how does it happen? What couples the inner part and the top of our world? We don't know that much about the inner part of our world, so can these fire and smoke pieces of land help us to understand it a little bit better? We use a lot of numbers in a computer to help us answer this question. When we think about how rocks move in the inner part of our world, the top of the world makes rocks cold and heavy, and they want to go down. And the innermost part of the world is hot and makes rocks go up. We found that when old, cold rocks go down into the inner part of our world, they can push other rocks around. When the cold rocks move towards each other near the bottom of the rock-filled inner part of our world, they push the hot rocks that lie there together from different directions. Because the old cold rocks are so much harder and stronger than the hot rocks, they can push both normal hot rocks and different, slightly heavier rocks around. Usually, these heavy rocks don't go up much, even though they are hot, because they are so heavy. Or when they go up, little pieces of them go up in the middle of a lot of normal rock. So that cannot explain why we see a mirror of their position and pieces of rock at the top of our world. But when strong, cold rocks push normal hot rocks against the edges of big blocks of these heavy hot rocks, there is no space for the heavy rocks to move to the side, and so they are dragged upwards, towards the top of our world, together with the normal hot rocks, moving in the form of huge fingers. The positions of the normal rocks and the heavy rocks in the upgoing fingers of rock mirror the areas of normal rocks and heavy rocks at the bottom of the rock-filled inner part of our world. When the finger reaches the top of our world, it makes a hot spot and forms pieces of land that breathe out fire and smoke. And because the hot spot has these different rocks from the bottom of our world, sometimes these pieces of land are made of different types of rocks. And the positions of these types of rocks show us where from the bottom of the rock-filled inner part of our world they come from. This means that the different rocks on small pieces of land can not only help us understand more about what rock types the inner part of our world is made of, but also where in the inner part of our world large blocks of these different rocks can be found.